Worthington now from Dowling Cheddar, and Worthington!
Some great moments, some of the famous names from two of English football's oldest clubs meeting for the first time in a Wembley final. Bolton Wanderers are on course for a truly great season, just one match away from qualifying for Europe for the first time and still in the Division One promotion race. The fans from Anfield have enjoyed more success than any others over the years, but there's only been one trophy in the last five seasons. Today's Liverpool are hungry for more. Hello, good afternoon from a very expectant Wembley Stadium. Two such famous names adds up, we hope, to a truly memorable final. Terry Venables and Ron Atkinson with us. I think most people, Terry, believe that if they can shed their nerves, it could be a memorable final.
I think it is. It's full of talent. I mean, both sides. I think it's a great thing for Bolton, the mere fact that they've kept their players together. There must have been temptation to let them go for the money and pressure put on them. They've kept them together and kept them, and they've found themselves in this final against Liverpool. I'm delighted for them.
Ron, would you say that Bolton really have to survive the first 20 minutes and keep their nerve?
I think so. I always think if you're the so-called underdogs, when you come to Wembley, the important thing is you don't concede. You don't chase the game, but you make sure the opposition don't get any early advantages. And I think that should be Bolton's play.
OK, now let's have a look, an early look at the two teams selected by Roy Evans and by Bruce Rioch. No real shocks, I guess.
No, not at all. I mean, they've got their familiar 4-4-2 Bolton, and of course Liverpool playing three central strikers, defenders, and then pushing their full-backs in, Bjornaby on the left and Rob Jones on the right.
And Bolton, Ron?
Yeah, they're pretty well settled. I mean, Bruce is a keen sort of follower of 4-4-2. He'll have his wingers, Lee and Thompson, working up and down the line. I think he'll cause them a lot of problems with McAteer. I think if Liverpool have a vulnerability, you know, I think energy in the middle of the field against them, a runner from midfield, can give them problems, and McAteer's as good as anything with that.
OK, let's just pause in our chat to look at a very special Liverpool character. At 33, he's in the twilight of his career, maybe, I say maybe, because he keeps creating records. He could get a record fifth winner's medal here today. Anyway, he's a striker, he's Welsh, he's Liverpool's skipper. We'll be right back. just some of the key players on show today here at Wembley Stadium, and what a beautiful day it is. And I hope the game's as lively as that music as well. But Terry and Ron, it's who and why time from you. Who do you think, Terry?
Well, I'm just going to go for Liverpool. I think it's going to be very tight. I think Bolton's got a lot of talent. They're well organised. They know what they're going to go out and set about to do against Liverpool. And Liverpool, you can get chances against them. I think John Barnes and Redknapp are get caught very close together. They have to be very accurate all the time. And if you can steal it off them there and run off them, I think you're into their back three very quickly. And that's what I think they've got to be very careful of.
Do you see it, Liverpool, Ron?
Yes, I must confess. I've fancied Liverpool since they beat Blackburn. I think that's probably the best result in the competition so far. And, you know, when they say your name's on the cup, I think that might be the time when I first thought they were going to win it.
Yeah. Well, one thing that all three of us can tell you is that Wembley here can be a nerve-wracking experience for experienced players, never mind first-timers. So how are those nerves holding up? Well, Gary Newbon and Jim Rosenthal are down pitch side, finding out for us.
Jason, a Liverpool fan through and through, for the first time in your life you're playing against them.
That's right, yeah. First time I'm going to actually play, and I played, I was sub against them in the FA Cup, which we won. But like you say, this is the first time I'm going to be playing against them, yeah.
You've seen it all before in the 92 Cup final, but is it still a bit special for you?
Of course, I mean, it's the pinnacle of everyone's career to reach Wembley in the final. People say this is the lesser final, but still, it guarantees one of the clubs a place in Europe, so I mean, very important.
Your first ever visit to Wembley?
That's right, yeah, I haven't been here before, and it's a glorious day to make it even a nicer day.
And I think from when you were a little kid, you dreamed about this day, didn't you, Mixer?
Absolutely, yeah. I mean, English football is followed very closely in Finland, and Wembley Stadium is the number one stadium in Europe, and even not in the world. And it's everybody's dream to play here, and thankfully today it's come true.
Ian, if Liverpool win today, you'll be the first player ever to win 5 winning medals.
Yeah, it's always nice individual performances. You know, it's always nice to get medals in that, but on a day, if we're going to win, it's going to be the team performance, like we've done against Manchester United and other teams. If we go individuals, we're not going to win, but it'd be really nice if I could do that.
You've had a look round the place. I mean, it's a terrific stadium, this Wembley. Do you think one or two of the boys might just be a little bit nervous?
Hopefully not. They've had some big games recently in the last couple of years, but obviously not as big as this. So we'll keep our fingers crossed that everything goes well.
You tend to score when you're on ITV.
Well, I hope you're right, Jim. No, it'd be nice. Aye, it'd be nice. Maybe it's a good omen.
Yeah, they're a very good side. I'm sure they won't be far away from coming up this year to the Premier League. They've got a lot of talented players. Like a few of them, if they don't go up, I think a few of them will be playing in the best teams in the country next year.
Everyone expects Liverpool to win, but we've got a few things up our sleeves. We're not going to come here and just lie down. We've come here to enjoy ourselves, and we're going to give them a hell of a game.
Bolton have beaten us already in the FA Cup. They've beaten Arsenal, Norwich, West Ham. They've beaten a lot of teams. But, you know, top final day just depends on who performs best. You know, if we perform to our capabilities, we should win. But unfortunately, it doesn't always go that way.
Does this cause a bit of a split in the McAteer family?
A little bit, yeah. All my mates don't know who to shout for. They say they're going to shout for me when I got the ball, but they'll cheer, I'm sure, if Liverpool score. But I'll have to try and pop one in and shut the ball off, I think.
Do you think Bolton can really do it?
Yeah, we've got every chance, you know. I mean, it's a big occasion. You know, everyone's on the same level here at Wembley. No one's at home or away. The crowd's going to be brilliant. So I think it's whoever's the form team on the day is going to get the result.
Well, you return to us as that great Liverpool anthem, You'll Never Walk Alone, is ringing around the famous old stadium. We reckon the temperature's around about the mid-60s here, and the teams are just on their way out. They're about to hit this wall of sound here. And Terry, just a word here, the Wembley pitch and the stage, I mean, do you think it's got any bearing at all on this outcome today?
Well, they'll just be looking at it. It's as I think Jason McAteer said, that it's something that you look forward to since you're a little boy. You play football to one day play here. And they're here, and they're just full of anticipation now and wanting to get on with it.
Really. A wonderful day, Ron, isn't it, for Roy Evans and Bruce Rioch, who we saw. You were here with Villa last year when you won it. Any little anecdotes when you're walking out there at this moment?
I think you're going to enjoy it. You've done your work. Obviously, you've got a little bit more to do during the game. But now's the time to say to the players,
You've worked hard to get here. Don't disappoint. Let's go and enjoy the occasion. But above all else, let's win.
And some figures who are important, Terry. Some players get stage fright at Wembley. Some respond as if born to it. We saw Ian Rush there, and we saw Alan Stubbs there, two key players today, the new captains.
I think it's particularly interesting that one is an underdog, and I think it's not quite right, because they're a really good team. I think it's going to be very close, this game. But when they're the underdog, they can feel, well, we've got nothing to lose. And really, the supposedly better side and better individuals add the pressure on them a little bit today.
Yes.
But as John Barnes says, if they can get it down and play, then they should win the game.
Jason McAteer, Ron, you feel is a key figure, don't you? There he is for Bolton.
Yeah, I think he's the most energetic midfield player on either side. This can sap his strength, a pitch like this, particularly under these conditions. But as he showed in the World Cup, he's capable of travelling from front to back for the whole of the game. And he would be a key for... He's got to play well for Bolton to play well.
Yes, and Razor Ruddock, Terry?
Well, he'll be looking forward to this. He loves the big game, the big stage. He'll just be waiting for that whistle to go, put his personality on the game, and he'll love every second of it.
Well, they're lining up the two teams to meet the guest of honour, the great Sir Stanley Matthews. It's enough from us for the moment. Time to join our men in the commentary box this afternoon. There's one who knows every blade of this Wembley turf from playing here. That's Kevin Keegan. And, of course, a man who's described over the years action on every inch of the Wembley turf, Brian Moore.
Well, it's a wonderful occasion, and it's Wembley weather, as they call it. So we're really looking forward to a great occasion here at the famous old stadium. And there is Sir Stanley Matthews, 80 years old last February. Really the people's champion, Stanley. Crowds loved him as much as they admired his skill. 38 years old when he won on that famous occasion back in 1953. 42 years old when he won his last cap, and 50 when he played his last league game. He really was an inspiration for all older players, and an inspiration for the younger ones as well, because in all his time he was never booked. Ian Rush doing the honours there with John Barnes.
Mark Seagraves, 6 Alan Stubbs,
Razor Ruddock, Bill Fab and Michael Thomas,
8
Mark Waters, and Sir Stanley, as keen a fan of the game as ever he was, with the Liverpool manager there, Roy Evans.
7 Alan Thompson, and substitutes number 12 Mark Manson.
If you talk about the 1953 FA Cup final, when Stanley Matthews put, ironically, Bolton Wanderers to the sword, and they call it the Matthews final. Stanley doesn't call it that, he says it's the Mortensen final. Morty with three goals in that famous game. Tell you something, there are going to be 90,000 headaches here this afternoon after that loudspeaker's finished. But here's this proud club of Bolton Wanderers. The first time in a major final in 37 years. 1958 was the last one, when they beat Manchester United by 2-0. Both the goals that day scored by their president, Nat Loftus. Jason McAteer, it's a terrific day for Bolton. And not least for their manager, Bruce Rioch. The heat's beginning to go out of the day. There is Bruce Rioch, who's turned this Bolton club around superbly. When he took over from Phil Neal, who was already doing a good job there. Philip Don, World Cup referee, former FA Cup final referee, European Cup final referee. And there's the proudest man from Bolton, their president, Nat Loftus.
Ladies and gentlemen, please, we are standing for the national anthem.
From our Mazda blip, as we now have the national anthem. teams are breaking away to flex their muscles. Let's have a look at the teams. Don't expect any major surprises in our team lineup, says Liverpool's Roy Evans, true to his word. The three centre-backs are there, Scales, Ruddock and Babb. Bjørnebye's better defensive qualities give him his place on the left side of defence. Ian Rush has recovered from that worrying hamstring injury and plays in his sixth League Cup final, four wins, one defeat. Let's have a quick word with Roy Evans.
I think the biggest strength that we've had all season that we've played as a team, and it's important today that we do that, okay, as individuals in that setting. And obviously we don't stifle any individual flair, but the most important thing is we play as a team, we work hard for each other, and that's where we've got our success from. This season we've challenged in all the major competitions, which I think has been satisfying from my point of view. But the attitude that they've shown in every game, really, they've not wanted to get beat, even when the odds have been against them on one or two occasions. They've rolled us through and they've fought hard, and that's why we've made a major final in the and progress running with the competitions.
Bolton, they're the dangerous underdogs with talent and a liking for hard work. The skipper Alan Stubbs, impressive in defence. As a captain too, Jason McAteer will certainly stir things up in the midfield. And Bruce Rieck has now decided to inject the potentially exciting talent of David Lee down the right flank. He's really got a winning touch against Liverpool in previous games. Here is Bruce Rieck.
We've won a lot of them against good teams, and not just Premiership clubs. We've won games against good teams in the Envy League, and they've been difficult teams to beat. But it's always on the day, and if you play well on the day and you take your chances, then you can win matches. We've got an experienced side. Although there's some good youth in the side, we've still got a team that's not old but experienced, and I think that's important for us at the moment.
Referee, as I've said, Philip Dawn from Hanworth Park in Middlesex, headmaster of Northbrook C of E School in Middlesex. As I say, already in charge of a 1992 FA Cup final, last season's European Cup final, and enjoyed the World Cup in the USA last summer. Alan Stubbs, the number six for Bolton, Ian Rush, the number nine for Liverpool, the two captains. And the substitutes, Patterson Bergson and the goalkeeper Davison. For Bolton, Walters Thomas and the goalkeeper Chamberlain. For Liverpool, the first word from Kevin Keegan. Your thoughts, Kevin?
Well, it's a classic tie, really. You know, the underdogs, certainly Bolton, but coming from the Ensley League, they're a really good cup side. They've already took Liverpool's scalp twice in the last three or four years, so they won't have any fear. And I think it'll be a fascinating game. I just wonder, Brian, how much the weather's going to play a part. It's really hot. It's more cricket weather than football weather. And I think that'll suit Liverpool because they do knock the ball around and they'll make the ball to the work, as they say.
Liverpool in red. Bolton in white. The 1995 Coca-Cola Cup final about to get underway. A place in Europe in the UEFA Cup next season at stake here this evening. On a beautiful, blissful summer's evening. And the first touch there for the Bolton keeper, Keith Brannigan. Bruce Rioch's first signing when he became manager of Bolton. There's McGinley. McAteer. Brannaman. And now Rush. Seagraves just getting there before him. Free kick given for Bolton. There had been some talk that Ruddock was going to wear a rubber headband, but obviously that hasn't materialised. And that stops then with the free kick. It went in towards McGinley, but Liverpool get it away to Barnes. Marking it now to Robbie Fowler. And Scott Green gets it back. Here's Stubbs. A real talent at the centre of the back for Bolton. A little flick on there. Ruddock will build this one up quite easily. There's a good, careful ball to Rush, and a good one it was. Rush getting it back again. Off McManaman. Scales. coming forward. Manaman again. Will need to be stopped. And they stopped him fairly. It's Stubbs coming out again, but Stubbs losing it. And there was a foul on the Bolton captain, and a free kick's already taken, but to no good effect.
Set your club alight, and the combination of Fowler and Rush is very, very exciting.
Well, going for that one with a head. By the way, that headband wasn't it from Fool? Did it fool you too?
Certainly did. But I'm easily fooled, right? You know?
Me too.
Struggling to get into our side, but with Scott Sellers getting injured this year, had he stayed, I'm sure he would have got a chance. But he's really matured, he's had a great season there, and full credit to the lad, he'll keep going to the end, that's for sure.
Here he is with a corner, flicked on, and plenty of Liverpool shirts at that near post to make sure there wasn't an effective flick on. Green now playing it to Jimmy Phillips. Phillips hitting it long, and it comes to Thompson again, asserting himself down that left flank. And then losing out, but unfairly. There was a foul there by McManaman, another free kick to Bolton. All the favourites being pushed back here. Seeking to win this trophy for the fifth time, a record fifth time. Regimental Sergeant Major is Bruce, the Scots Guards, and he loves discipline and good order. And he's got a side here at Bolton that's going to a good, sensible pattern here. And they're really carrying the fight at the moment to Liverpool. Phillips hitting it in towards McGinley. Catalanans in the middle waiting. Phillips coming up fast. Sneakers trying to get something on the turn also, and McAteer in there too.
It's an interesting start, Brian. I'm fascinated with the three centre halves that Liverpool play, because it's something I want to do at Newcastle, and we never really got the chance to do it properly with the injury to Philippe Albert. But it's worked very well for them, because it allows Bjørneby, and more importantly Jones, to get forward, and really they are very, very good use of the ball. But Bolton have got strength up front, and that's where I think the game could be won and lost today.
But also, praise be, Bolton got two out-and-out wingers, haven't they? Thompson and Lee.
Well, that again is great tactics, because the best way to combine two people who are good going forward is make them defend, and I think that's what Bruce Rea's trying to do.
Arms finding McManaman. Might be a shot on here. Charged down, effectively too. Jason McAteer. Liverpool throw.
a great stage for someone like Jason McAteer. You know, we've seen him play very well in the cup matches, and if you sort of do it on this stage, you sort of go up in everybody's estimation.
Oh, Fowler, a chance, a mistake by Seagraves. And a chance that was thrown away by the man who's already hit the target 28 times this season. But it was an error there by Mark Seagraves. And Fowler, the youngest player on the field, way over the top. Never played at Wembley before. Twice only here has he been as a spectator. Sneaker's header going straight to Barnes. Now McManaman making one of those characteristic bursts through the middle and then collides with Fowler. Barnes picks it up again. McManaman knocking it back for Bjørneby. Crossed in again there. And easy for Brannigan from Fowler's header. Thompson down the flank. Bjørneby. Played for Scotland in the league in Russia. An excellent 0-0 draw the Scots got there. McAteer. Phillips. Scales with a header for Liverpool.
I think Terry Venables made the point before the game that really Bolton got the rewards for keeping older players that they could well have cashed in on. And, you know, it's nice when that happens. I'm sure the supporters appreciate it. They could have turned money on for McAteer, that's for sure, and possibly one or two other players. They've kept them, and they're now in a Coca-Cola Cup final at Wembley, having a great day out.
Well, Liverpool themselves have made a very strong inquiry, both for McAteer and for Stubbs in the last close season. I don't think a fee was ever talked about, but people are talking that it may have cost something around £6 million for the two of them. Must have been a great temptation for Bolton, but they've stuck to their players, as you say. Their reward is here this afternoon.
Alan Thompson finds himself back as a left back, but that won't bother him, Brian. He's played there many times.
You're going to be dinking it in. Ruddock there with an important header, but also a good clearance by McAteer. And here's Lee. It's the first real chance and the first real taste he's got. He's cut inside bad. He is such an exciting player, but this time the Liverpool door closed swiftly on him. Here's Barnes. Misguided booze, presumably from the Bolton fans. There were plenty here at Wembley the other night, but he's such an experienced player, Barnes, he's not going to let that worry him. Good challenge there by Phillips. McGinn is up, and Patalainen from Finland is up as well. Over Patalainen's head, Bjørneby. Back to David James. Turned well, but not such a good ball for Lee.
He hasn't had the best of starts, as Stubbs. You know, I mean, he is a player a lot of people have looked at. He got caught twice on the ball early on. His use of the ball there could have been better, but he is very influential at the back for them. If he gets on his game, then they start to play. At the moment, he hasn't started to play.
Here's McManaman. Jones. McManaman. coming on in leaps and bounds again this season, Redknapp. There he is again. Oh, just tried to quicken it up with a little ball there to Rush, but McAteer read that well. Here's McManaman, a bit of space. Still McManaman. Fowler's cross is too far, too high for Rush. Beyond the byline in any case, goal kick.
Yeah, he would have expected to do better there, Brian, because it's on his left side. Obviously, he's got a super left foot. But just overhits it, really. He had more time, I think, than he thought. I mean, the ball is running away, but he gets there quite comfy. Look, a couple of metres from the line. He doesn't deliver.
Redknapp's header. Stubbs getting enough on that header to get it back to Brannigan. Scott Green, used to be a midfielder. Formerly with Derby County. Braddock holding off Patalainen. John Scales. It's Jamie Redknapp. McManaman. It's the freedom really to play where he feels he can be most effective, and here he is now hopping on this left hand side. Wannabe. Barnes. Just think what the likes of Redknapp and McManaman are learning for Barnes over the years. Here's Barnes again. That's a little ball play forward again for Fowler. And he's got a shot on target that time that Brannigan had to get down to.
Again, a superb build-up here. But watch this man's running for, I mean, what is he, 19, coming on 20? And he, if he gets it through his legs, he possibly scores. And that's how he gets a lot of his goals. He does hit the target an awful lot. Had him with the under-21s, and I was very, very impressed with him.
20 next week, he is.
He's only a baby.
Here's Lee. Again for Green. McAteer. Lee just kept in play. McAteer. Cross it towards Patalainen. Going to Bolton from Aberdeen. Lee. Green. McAteer again, full of running, but noticeable that quickly Liverpool were onto him. Not one Ruddock, but two with Barnes as well there. Recognising the threat that McAteer has with those sort of runs. Ruddock with a header, Lee with the shot, but he half hit it. But there was a fraction of a chance there, Kevin.
Yeah, unfortunately for Lee, it came on his least favourite foot, I think. But this if he hits the target through a ruck of players, he could have scored, but the... He won't be wanting the replay of that one too often. He didn't quite catch it. He cut the neck off it, as we say, Brian.
Fowler took a knock there. And challenge with Stubbs. Here's Ruddock. Fab. Here, Barnes just got a foot to it. Foul by Scales. And a free kick then. In with the injured man. To them, John McGinley. Superb view from the airship. 17 goals McGinley this season. 33 last. That's the Maslow blip again. And down below it's this famous old stadium, which shows the score still at 0-0. With 16 minutes gone. Now McGinn is okay. It's a free kick for Bolton. to be their skipper, Alan Stubbs, who takes it. In towards McGinley, then by Patalainen. McAteer pumping it forward. And Jones really couldn't afford to wait that tap to go over the byline. Had to hook it away. Helped on its way by McManaman. Here's Redknapp. Straight to Green. Played in for McGinley. Now McAteer. McAteer! Brought down. Wow, that certainly looked a free kick on the edge of the box there, but Philip Don was well enough placed. But another example of the talent of Jason McAteer. And now let's look at Lee. Really had Liverpool backpedalling there. Lee, a good cross there. James comfortably underneath that one.
That was a terrific run from McAteer. This is when he's at his best, really. He's not a midfield player who knocks it around. He likes to run at the people. He's got tremendous strength. He's unfortunate not to get a free kick there, Brian. I mean, a lot of referees would have given it, but the referees saw it differently.
Talking to Jack Charlton about him the other day, he said, I think at the moment he's the finest player when he's got the ball at his feet and he's running at people. And he gave a little example of that there.
Yeah, and you're running at these centre-halves, and that's the one thing that Ruddock and probably Scales more than Babb don't want you to do. And that's what he's got to keep trying to do. Get on, use his tremendous engine, which he's got, and get in on that back four, because that's where they're most vulnerable. Running from deep is always difficult to combat as a defender.
That was up for a moment for offside, but the referee with Bolton in possession. Now the game to go on. It's Phillips. Good left foot on him, but that's straight to Bjornaby. And here's McManaman picking it up. To get past Green, he certainly has, knocking it back for Rush.
Another great run here, and he just used his strength really, which he's not renowned for, and then his pace, which everyone knows he's got. Great ball back, not easy for Ian Rush, again on his left foot, it's not his strongest foot, but I've seen him score goals from that sort of position lots of times.
To Thompson, and the flag is up for offside. Richard Sneakers, the Dutchman. Adelainen picks that up. Rather carelessly given away there by Liverpool. Lee has made a good break down the right. By Babb, and Babb will get a yellow card.
I think he's unfortunate to get a yellow card for this. There's no doubt about it, it's a foul. This is pace against pace here. They both got it. I think you can see he genuinely tries to win the ball. But that now is a real plus point for the forwards of Bolton, because, you know, they can start running at him, another foul like that, and who knows?
A little knot of white shirts waiting for Thompson's free kick, but it's Barnes with the header who gets it clear for McManaman. Just Robbie Fowler up. Phillips gets it away. Sneakers.
One thing that's really clear, Brian, is that Bolton are not overawed by the task, are they? They're taking the game to Liverpool when it's the right time to do so. And they've got players who I think are capable of causing them problems.
Adelainen, Lee. Actually, one of the things that Roy Evans was worried about was the lack of Wembley Cup final experience in his side. They're certainly the favourites, Liverpool, but as he was saying, you know, without Barnes and without Rush, we are lacking a little bit in Cup final experience.
That's certainly the case, but in those two, they've got a tremendous foundation on which to build their team of the future. And it's a shame to hear John Barnes getting booed again here, because he must think that there's people staying inside this Wembley Stadium having a go at him.
Here's Jones. Little flick ball there towards Fowler. And the pressure from Stubbs, who went stumbling. The referee didn't consider anything there. That was never a penalty. Redknapp now to Ruddock. And here's Babb. Babb, actually, who was given a free transfer by Bruce Rioch when Bruce was manager at Millwall. Sometimes your past judgments in football come back to haunt you, it seems.
Nearly always they do, Brian.
Arms stopped well there by Seagraves. Former Liverpool player himself, Mark Seagraves. Phillips. Oh, that was a poor ball. Phillips, Madalainen, Thompson, McAteer, Seagraves now to Lee. And they might struggle to get that one back. It's Rush, playing it short to Redmond. Going to be Barnes. There's the skipper, Ian Rush. Fowler. And Alec Manaman. White shirts are backpedaling. Going to be playing it in, perhaps too close to the keeper. Let's have a quick word with Terry Venables. Terry, how do you think it's going so far?
Well, I think they look very sharp indeed, Liverpool. Bolton are holding their own quietly, getting confident and building some play up both sides of the field. But I think the danger for them is Fowler making these runs behind central defenders, which is their weakness. And you'll see McManaman playing both wide areas, plus little sneaky positions through the centre of the field. He's giving them the danger. They can't pick him up at the moment, and he does look a threat.
Have you been impressed by McAteer so far?
Yes, he's showing you what he can do, and I think he looks as if he's really enjoying himself, and the more the game's going on, the more he's getting into it. And as I said, he does run off of our Liverpool midfield players, and he is quickly into the three central defenders, and that's what I said that he would be able to do.
Thank you, Terry. Here's Lee. Snickers. Jimmy Phillips. Down the line for Alan Thompson. He's done well again down that flank. Came off scales, might come back to Thompson in the end. Rob Jones, who's nobody's mug, has a couple of times been beaten quite comfortably by Thompson. Bolton's corner. Both Stubbs and Big Mark Seagraves are up for this. Catalining in there, McGinley at the near post. Seagraves looking for the little flick on. Stubbs there, just holding it up for a moment. Floating it in. And a shout from keeper David James. And a throw out now for Robbie Fowler. It's a good ball play for Babb. Redknapp just eluding the challenge of Richard Snickers. Find McManaman. Seagraves does enough to get the ball clear. McAteer then brings it forward. Babb knocking it in again. Rush knocking it down. McManaman's here. Babb has gone right into the box now. Driven far too hard by McManaman. And it just falls for Alan Thompson of Bolton on the far side. 25 minutes gone. Still no score. Scales gets it back to James. Lovely ball by Redknapp. Robbie Fowler getting in behind the defenders again. And finds Bjørneby, who's never scored for Liverpool. Good work by Fowler there.
Excellent again. And he at the moment is the biggest influence on the game. And Bjørneby's done what he can. He's hit the target, but obviously straight down the goalkeeper's throat.
Open throw. Dear. David Lee. Back to Scott Green. Long towards McGinley, but a direct shot behind him. And a great shot by McAteer. Flicked on there beautifully and with power by the outside of that right boot. Fortunately, Liverpool straight at David James.
Again, McAteer running from deep. It's so hard to pick him up. And he strikes this well. Again, he just unfortunate straight at the keeper.
As we're saying, Bolton by no means overawed by Liverpool or the occasion. Yonaby. Snakers. It's no foul. McManaman takes it on. In a sense, why should Bolton be overawed? If you look at their recent record against Premiership sides, they beat Liverpool in 1993 in the FA Cup. They beat Everton, Villa and Arsenal in the FA Cup last season. And in getting to this final in the Coca-Cola Cup this season, they've already beaten Ipswich, West Ham and Norwich from the Premiership. As I say, they are dangerous underdogs here today.
And also, Brian, it's not beyond possibility they could be a Premiership side next year. They're having a great season and they've got games in hand and there's still a lot to play for there. So they've really kept the players who could be Premier League and hoping they get them there themselves. And they deserve some reward for that adventure.
It's Bolton's throw.
The one thing that slightly worries me for Bolton is that the two players up front, McGinley and Lennon, they're not going to really worry Liverpool with the pace behind them. And therefore, they've got to get hold of it. And of course, against the strength of Liverpool's back four, they're finding that difficult at the moment.
Barnes dispossessing Snakers. Yonaby's gone down the left. There's a little ball in here for Fowler. Redknapp. Towards Fowler on the far side. Back by Phillips. Scales versus Papalino. Scales knocks it back. Great calm play there by David James. Barnes again. Jones down the right flank for him. You want to be down the left flank for him. Manaman through the centre, but he lost himself there for a moment. McAteer finds Lee, gets it back again to Jason McAteer. And plays the ball now for Lee. James is out of his goal. And Lee, it's just gone over the top and hit the roof of the netting. Great play by Bolton.
Another great ball from Jason McAteer, the two biggest influence on the game at the moment are two of the younger players. That's a great ball because this guy has got pace. And really, he'll be disappointed, I think. He only had to lift it over him, which he did, of course, but he's over it by about 2 yards. What a great ball this is, Brian. And there's no way anyone's going to catch this guy because one thing he has got is pace.
Barnes. Beautiful ball played there by Barnes, inviting McManaman onto it. There's a good ball too for Rob Jones from Jamie Redknapp. The cross comes in. Fowler. Tangling with Lee. Almost gets it back again. Babb following up now for Liverpool. Plays it short for John Barnes. Scales. Sigolke. Quick word from Ron Atkinson. Ron?
Yeah, very interesting. Contrasting styles. Liverpool very fluid, moving all over the place. McManaman switching from flank to flank, playing behind the front two. Bolton very rigid. It's been a long time since I've been at Wembley and seen a team play with two wingers so wide. I mean, David Lee on this side is virtually steering the touchline. And you saw the benefit of it just when McAteer played him in. I mean, that's possibly the best chance of the game at the moment, Rob.
Thank you, Ron. Hanneman. Liverpool throw. Rush and a goal kick. Terrific day out for all these Bolton fans. I suppose the Liverpool fans have got used to it over the years, but it's if you think the streets of Bolton are pretty empty on this beautiful afternoon. The local paper, the Bolton Evening News, did a wonderful Wembley supplement. They sold all their 33,000 tickets in double quick time. There are people around who like to talk down this Coca-Cola Cup. You just have a word with those Bolton fans and see what they think about it.
That's a club with great tradition as well, and this will be one of the best sides they've had for many, many years, so it's no surprise that they got to a final and they possibly can go on and win it. There's no doubt about it. At the moment, the game's pretty even, Stephen.
Sneakers or Bolton. Green. Ball through to McGinley. Babb was aware that Jason McAteer was right at his heels.
I'll be interested to see if McAteer can keep these runs going. I mean, it's a very hot day, and of course Wembley's it's not renowned for saving your energy at a pitch where you don't get some reward. Usually cramp is the reward for hard work here. It'll be interesting to see. He's obviously a young lad and very fit. He'll be tested to the full on this pitch on a day like today.
Remember him though in Florida in the World Cup though, Kevin, when if anything it was even hotter when he was playing for the Republic of Ireland there.
Yeah, but they might be able to throw water on today, that's the good news.
That's right.
I mean, I thought it was farcical in the World Cup that they, but really for purposes of getting it on TV around the world at the right times, ask players to play in ridiculous temperatures and humidity and then say you can't have any water. It was like a death threat for me, really.
Thompson with a shot! Terrific shot it was, and an excellent piece of goalkeeping there by James. Thompson caught that superbly on the volley as the ball was coming down. And this looked goal-bound. On its way down, on its way up, on its way in, no, just flicking the top of the crossbar after that excellent piece of goalkeeping by James. Corner to Bolton, and the closest we've come to a goal yet. A little flicking towards the near post. Ruddock there guarding that near post. Seagraves couldn't get a touch on it. Green to Lee. Thompson. What a great shot that was by him. Green playing it in again. And Jones looking to turn it away. Ball for Rush. And now Redknapp. Good turn. Turning again away from McGinley, finding Barnes. Gornaby into Fowler. Gornaby's gone on. Rush is waiting as well. No obstruction there as Fowler ran into the opponent.
Liverpool fans not happy about that one, but I don't think any of the options. But this is a tremendous shot. This is his swinger, really. He's a left-footed player. And you mustn't underestimate this save. That's one of the great saves of the season for me. And any goalkeeper who wasn't 6 foot three would not have got it. No doubt about it.
Carolinum. Thompson. Phillips outside it. Goalkeeper.
Start they've showed. I mean, his team are playing with plenty of confidence. They're a different type of style of play to Liverpool, there's no doubt about that. But nevertheless, it's been quite effective at certain times.
Thompson again. David James with that jockey cap over a head that looks as though he's shaved all his hair off for this cup final. Former Watford player.
Certainly had a close shave a minute ago. It was a great saver.
Barnes. McManaman.
Can he finish it off? He has! McManaman for Liverpool!
On the cards, and this is a great run, and he doesn't just stop and have a shot, he goes on. I think the goalkeeper, he nutmegs someone here yet. The goalkeeper will think he may have done better, Brian. He's laid down a little bit early and sold himself, but it's a great run, and this is where he is so difficult to stop. Here he goes, takes on one. Nutmeg.
Terrific goal. And he's only scored one since October until today. The boy from Bootle has put Liverpool 1-0 ahead. It's with Phillips. It's with Stubbs, and he's hit it long, seeking David Lee, and he's found him. Okay. They give him that free roll, don't they, McManaman? And he's really used it to perfection here so far this afternoon.
Yeah, it's so difficult to pick up, Brian. You know, defenders don't want to come out, and midfield players don't want to go so deep and or so wide. But nevertheless, when he picked it up, a great little early ball from John Barnes started it off. He won't get much praise from anybody, but he just gave it to him just when he wanted it, and then off he went on his way. And as they say, the rest is history now. But a great goal.
Phillips with a header for Bolton. In goes Redknapp. Oh, getting a little bit caught up. Barnes losing it out to McGinley, but Redknapp winning it back again. And suddenly, Bolton on the break. And a line on the far side. Getting the cross in. But James has had it. He's lost it. He's got it the second time, right on the edge of the penalty area.
It's a great cross he delivers here, Brian. There's only one man in there. Keeper comes, gets half on it, and then goes all the way and just keeps hold of it. Has a little wry smile at the end of it there to say, I knew I could get it.
McManaman with another good run there, but this time it came to nothing. Here's Snakers, the Dutchman, played here for Holland under-15s a few years back. Patalainen losing out to Scales. Barnes playing the careful ball, a simple ball again to McManaman. Finds Bjørneby. It's going to be a corner.
I think it. Vital time, really, for Bolton. I mean, what, with 7 minutes before half-time, is it?
Five.
You mustn't concede another goal, because you can't give teams like Liverpool a two-goal start. But they've nothing to be worried about at 1-0. They're still creating enough chances and giving enough problems to Liverpool, but they mustn't concede another one, and this is a vital time for them.
Well, Jamie Redknapp with his corner. Rush at the far post. Fowler in there as well. Barnes on the penalty spot. And three men, including Ruddock and Scales, just on the edge of the box. This might come for McManaman, driven in. Rush, battling away. Well, Babb on the far side now. And the keeper grabbed it well. Here's this goal again, Kevin.
Yeah, I mean, it's just sheer pace, really. And he goes on. He has his bit of luck there, there's no doubt about it. Maybe a bit critical of the keeper. I just felt he should have stood up a bit longer. He may well have saved it, but it's easy sitting up here watching it. But he made a decision to come out, and he got half a touch on it, but he couldn't stop it going over the line.
Bolton's free kick. Green with it. Jones hitting away. What a bad one, though. Looking forget, coming up at half-time, there's our special competition for you, a VIP trip to the European Champions Cup final in Vienna for £1,000 for you. Also at half-time, you've got Terry Venables responding to the criticism about England's performance last Wednesday, which will be worth listening to as well. That all comes up with Bob at half-time. Barnes, and now it's Redknapp, Liverpool leading 1-0, Jones, Redknapp, McManaman, here he goes again.
They're really struggling to pick this guy up, and I know we played them about 4 weeks ago and we had the same problem. You just don't know who to put on him, but he's certainly, if his shooting boots are a bit better, he's had two or three other opportunities. But he'll be pleased with his haul from the first half, a goal. A performance that really is beyond his years, is maturing very quickly.
Right, every time he gets it, there's a tremor in the Bolton defence, isn't there?
Yeah, because he's running at them, Brian, and defenders don't like that. And other than put a man on him and change totally the way you play, which in some way gives the advantage, I think, to the opposition. But it's something they might talk about at half time, because he's certainly been the thorn in the side more than anybody else, and along with Fowler, I think, up front.
Akatea to Sneakers, to Mark Seagraves. Came off Ruddock, but Akatea, what if Bjørneby played a good ball here for Barnes, flicked on by him, but Sneakers just gets in for Bolton's. Seagraves now to Lee. Bolton have had their chances, and it's taken one superhuman save from James to keep out that shot from Thompson. So there's still plenty in this game as Redknapp finds Barnes, back to Redknapp again. Rush's little touch, falls straight to Seagraves. Phillips, Sneakers. Sneakers again. Shooting range, either the Dutchman. He is on the ball again. A little flick. He is again. This time to McAteer. This time Redknapp. Full of confidence there. McManaman. Rush. Some like Rush to give that away to Thompson. That's conceding a free kick. And a yellow card against Rob Jones. Probably as much for dissent as for the challenge.
I can't believe it was for the challenge. I mean, it's a 50-50. They lean on each other.
But it's what he does afterwards that probably angered referee Philip Dorney. Showed a high degree of dissent. He's conceded the free kick. He's got a yellow card. It's a free kick for Bolton. Right on half-time. Knocked in low this time. Barnes, who got it away. Thompson again. Back with the header clear. As far as David Lee. McManaman playing it on. Back to Brannigan. And here's Green. Another foul, another free kick. This time Scales on McGinley. Another chance perhaps for Bolton to rescue themselves in the last seconds of the first half. Alan Stubbs up to take this one. Although Sneakers, who's got a reputation for hitting spectacular long-range shots, might fancy one himself, and here he is. He's driven it well, but he drove it straight at John Barnes. Stubbs, not quite again. Seagraves right out there. He tries to think that the big centre-back was away on the left of the wing position.
Now you know why he's a centre-back, Ryan, as well. He looked like a centre-back crossing that one.
Summing up the first half, Kevin?
I think it's been a very interesting first half. I don't think there's any doubt that possibly on the play that Liverpool deserved maybe to be ahead more than Bolton save, but Bolton certainly had the chances, and the crucial changing point in the first half was that great save from James, and then within 2 or 3 minutes Liverpool have got the lead, and it was a terrific save. I mean, as I said before, not many keepers would have got that.
Well, there's the half-time whistle, David James with that incredible save. And immediately afterwards, with Steve McManaman still, let's have a word with the Liverpool manager, Roy Evans.
Roy Evans, two very important minutes there. Great save by James, and then your goal.
Great save from David James, comes in the game, and we've got on the other end. But we need to pass it better and keep control of the game. We've been a bit sloppy with our passing today. We've got to improve on that.
Thank you.
Welcome back to Wembley Stadium. The favourites have the lead here. Liverpool are leading 1-0 against Bolton Wanderers. Do you think Liverpool will be relieved slightly, Terry?
Well, I thought it was fairly even, and they both had a prominent player in forward running. McAteer for Bolton was a constant threat, and McManaman, we'd said right from the beginning and through the game, he was finding space, he's given them a lot of problems, and it was McManaman that broke the deadlock.
Well, let's have a look at the goal, because, I mean, it was a terrific run from him, wasn't it? I mean, he does have this confidence to run at people.
He picks the ball up here. In fact, he's got a passing option to his left, which we can't see, which is Fowler. Draws the defenders in, but still decides to go it alone. He outstrips and gets a little break here on the two. Stubbs tries to get back in the picture. Goalkeeper leaning backwards, and really, he sees the ball late, and he's got no strength in his legs.
Ron?
Yeah, I mean, apart from the finish, it's an exciting run, and there's a little cross run which gives him a chance. I mean, that opens a gap for him. He drives for the gap. He may have had a little bit of luck there not making Phillips. And Terry said maybe the keeper will think on a good day to save that.
I think he's just falling backwards slightly. Keith Branigan's just going backwards, isn't he?
Yeah, but when you see somebody bearing down on you like that, as you would well know from about 5 or 6 yards
out. I'd be lying down.
I can remember.
But also, it came at the end of a very good passing movement. It was a great ball out from the back from Ruddock into Barnes, who played a sharp little ball to set McManaman on his run.
Yeah. Terry mentioned, obviously, McAteer as the key man for Bolton. And, I mean, he featured there in a couple of chances. One where he had his own shot at goal and one where he set one up, Ron. This is the chance, but for himself.
Oh, he's played well. The ball just drops out to the edge of the box. And he's latched onto this very early. He's hit it first time. Unfortunately, he's just happened to hit it straight at the keeper. I mean, he didn't have a chance to pick a spot there. He's just had to go and pop it.
But this one, this is the lead chance, and it's McAtee who sets it up with that little ball in.
Oh, it's a brilliant ball in behind the left side of the Liverpool defence. I actually think Lee thought that was going to run onto the keeper. It did. I mean, we got a first-class view of it here, and the ball seemed to die at the end of it, which made Lee favourite, and maybe he should have done better at the end of the day.
I thought David James perhaps had a touch of the grobbelaars there and shouldn't have gone out there, Terry, but he certainly made up for it with a magnificent save just after it.
Well, they just have a little crossover, ordinary little crossover move, and the Liverpool have all sorts of trouble with it. He gets the space, it sits up lovely for him, he gets a good look at it, and he hits it up and dips at the last minute, and it is a sensational save.
6'4", he needs every fibre. Little centimetre
exactly.
Doesn't he?
Yeah, I mean, that's a tremendous save. It's a great effort, as Kevin Keegan said, by Thompson's so-called wrong foot. Just a bit disturbed. That's the second or third time that's happened. Liverpool defence losing people.
Yeah, Rob Jones, you wouldn't have been too happy with Rob Jones on that throw-in, would you?
Well, I thought they could have passed over, and they've decided to stay with the runners, and it's given them a little bit of problem just from a normal throw.
Yeah. The great thing has been, I mean, Bolton, I guess really with all their success against Premiership sides, they've not been overawed at all, Ron, have they?
No, actually, I felt a little bit sorry for them because I thought they'd weathered the storm. I thought Liverpool once or twice early on had a few chances that Fowler might have exploited with his little darts behind the defence. And I just thought then, hey, they're getting into the game. They've seen it off, they're getting in control, and then the goal goes against them. That was a bad blow for them.
Yeah. Okay, thanks for the moment. We're just going to get into our competition time now and a chance for you to win a VIP trip for two to the Champions Cup final. That's in Vienna on May the 24th. You can take £1,000 in cash if you prefer that. Now, the question, well, that concerns David Platt, the England captain, now playing for Sampdoria. Now, we want to know David Platt's previous club in Italy. Was it A, Juventus, or B, AC Milan? And the number to ring is 0891 10 15 10. 0891 10 15 10. And the lines are open until midday on Thursday. Now, Terry, just before we go to a little break, I want to ask you, I want to bring you back to last Wednesday, the goalless draw, England against Uruguay. For the first time, really, not in your career, but for the first time, you had a bad press.
I'm glad you qualified that.
Yes.
Because I have had my odd moments.
And now and again.
Well, I've got to look at it over a period of time, seven games, and on that I felt they were like anticipating to get into us and the team a bit too early, the press. I felt that wasn't the one to do it with. Although it was very disappointing from the entertainment value. And as I said on the night, if you don't score, people do get frustrated. But I think in the main, the press have been quite consistent. They're interested. They want us to do well. But I think there are certain two or three tabloids, to be fair, that are not really interested in that side. They want to sell newspapers.
They're destructive, and the whole, aren't they, rather
and the
than
whole,
constructive?
Our whole business, the professional game, are very concerned about it because, you know, we don't even feel, and the players don't feel, they actually want you to win. They just... newspaper selling is more important, and the problem is it's successful. They do sell a lot. Perhaps a lot of people are interested in that type.
One player, Terry, was singled out. Goodness me, he's getting singled out again today. John Barnes. I mean, what is going on here?
I was just going to say, sorry, Ron, I'll come in a second. I've always, and I think we've always felt, when you boo your own team, there's nothing worse than that. Can't stand it. It's like a fair weather friend that's with you, and then when things are going bad and you need them, they go against you. And I think that really is what it is. And he doesn't need that, and it becomes a sort of cult. All of a sudden today they're booing him again. I find it incredible.
A quick comment for you on that.
Well, I thought against Uruguay in the second half, I thought he looked the player most likely to produce something alongside Anderson. I certainly think today he's been probing and prompting, and he's played some smashing passes. His combinations with Redknapp and McManaman have been superb today. I think
thank you, Ron. Well, coming up after the break, the second half of the Coca-Cola Cup final. At the moment, it's Liverpool 1, Bolton Wanderers 0. Well, as the teams come back out here at Wembley, let's hear from the Bolton manager, Bruce Rioch. He's talking to Gary Neubauer.
Bruce, what have you said to them to pull them round in there?
Well, at the moment, we're getting overrun a bit in the middle of the park. And if you go chasing in the middle of the park, then you're going to leave yourself vulnerable to balls pushed through to McManaman. So whilst we can stay with our 4-2-4 and tighten it up a bit, we're not going to go chasing in the middle of the park. But really, go out and play without any fear. Just go out and play, and everybody get up in support of each other a bit better, pass the ball a bit better, a lot better to each other, but don't play with any fear.
You still think you can pull it round?
Of course.
Thanks, Bruce.
Well, Bruce talking there, of course, to Jim Rosenthal. Let's now go back to Brian Moore.
Thank you, Bob. Let's see if Bolton can play without any fear. They certainly put in a fearless first half performance. They went down by Steve McManaman's goal to nil. And here they are, Snakers, hitting it wide on the far side. Here comes Lee. Rush. And the left is Bjørneby. And he plays the ball in quickly here. And Phillips allowed it to run as Fowler was closing in on him. Phillips. Snakers.
Oh, a bad mistake there, and Rush
almost was able to capitalise on it. And now Stumps. Driving that ball forward, getting McGinley. James is away out of his goal, and Petalainen just wide. Oh, there's a warning for Liverpool.
Yeah, real warning, Brian, and he was unlucky. I mean, he did ever so well to get such a good strike on him, but I don't know what David James is doing running out in this situation. And there's no doubt about it, if he hits the target, there's not a lot he can do.
Well, the fin was no more than a yard wide with that one. And it was McGinley, really, who did such good work down that right flank to set it up in the first place. A good, strong surging run. And the Stubbs have hit him well.
He delivered it so early. It's always difficult to defend against an early ball. And Liverpool had problems there, but it was really caused by a mistake for me.
Well, that will certainly encourage Bolton. Jones just looking in. Redknapp to McManaman to Rush. Thompson. Neatly tricking Ian Rush. Ran out of partners. Here Scales. Jones. Redknapp. Barnes. In stops Seagraves. And Fowler got 10 yards offside. Roy Evans and Ronnie Moran. Livermore on the left there. I mean, you've played with Liverpool, Kevin. You've watched them and admired them for so many years. How will they now play this second half?
Well, they won't change anything. They'll just keep knocking it around. Of course, Wembley suits them. It's a fast pitch. Tailor-made for knocking it around and movement, which is what Liverpool's all about. And that's what Roy Evans has instilled again. You know, it's pretty simple the way they play, but it's very hard to combat.
Here's Rush. And Fowler chasing this one. It's a goal kick.
They had this young man in the under-21s when I filled in for Dave Sexton for two games, and we were in Austria, and his finishing is just unbelievable. He seems to hit the side netting every time, but not outside, inside. Tremendous finisher. I'm very impressed with his attitude. Unfortunately, he got sent off in the game, but he was very unfortunate to get sent off. But he did impress me.
Here's Snakers impressing us all with the way he turned Redknapp there. McAteer playing it forward. Here's Thompson. There could be something here. It's across the face of the Liverpool goal again. And they've made two good chances for themselves. But there's still a goal down. And the fans are now beginning to rise and get behind them.
It's a great ball here. He's not offside. He's level at best. He just might have dinked it over him. He went for power. And he's just pulled it, what, 2 yards wide again? He's having a tremendous game, Alan Thompson.
Liverpool have shown nothing in this second half coming forward. So far, that's all come from Bolton. Katalainen just a fraction wide, and now Thompson wide. Phillips. Supported by Seagraves. Snakers. Scott Green. No, that was a lazy ball played inside there. Barnes hitting a perfect ball from McManaman. Oh, what a good ball there by McManaman. Rob Jones taking it up. Barnes available. It's got Fowler available. Lee will clear it now for Liverpool, but very poorly. Straight to Bjørneby. Cross comes in. Seagraves stuffing in to get that one away. Liverpool's throw. Bjørneby with it. Here's Jamie Redknapp. Hanneman. Oh, my goodness. That was a ridiculous challenge by Thompson. If he'd caught the man there, well, I think he might well have been off the field.
I think he'll book him. He'll wait till this play stops and then he'll book him for that. I'm sure of that, because that's the way Philip Don works. He's playing advantage.
But he's keeping his eye on Thompson as well.
He won't let him out of his sight, I can tell you that.
Here's Thompson on the ball now. Playing it back. It's a very interesting piece of refereeing, because he's waiting a long, long time if he is going to book him.
Oh, he doesn't forget and book the wrong player, but he's going to book him, I'm sure of it. I'd have money on it. There you go.
And he goes. You've got it right, Kevin. Spot on. Excellent bit of refereeing as well. In no way did Philip Don hold up the game. He allowed it to go. In his mind, he knew what he had to do for that ridiculous challenge by Alan Thompson. And, a yellow card, just look at this.
Maybe a bit of frustration, Whoosh. Brian, that's the only excuse you can make for him, but had he caught him, I doubt whether McManaman played any part in the game anymore.
Here's Bjørneby, he's coming forward so much as Bjørneby, this time finding Ian Rush. He's got Seagraves right there with him, he's played the in for Bjørneby! Oh, against the post!
Hanneman turning it in,
and Stubbs taking it on that ample chest of his and bringing it away. Well, a long searching ball, but it finds Phil Babb, and David James whacks it away before McGinley can come in. Flag up for an offside. What about this one, Kevin?
Oh, it's a great ball back. He does ever so well to hit the target, but he's never going to score for Liverpool, is he? You said he hadn't scored. I didn't realise that. But that's as close as he surely must have come. Great ball from Rush, through the legs of the defender. And a great run from Bjornaby. But until you get that second goal, there's always... We proved that at Chelsea on Saturday. We were never in the game for long periods, but we kept sticking at it, and in the end we got a draw because they never killed us off. And I think Southampton did that to us the other week. 1-0 up with 4 minutes to go. We'd missed various chances. Next thing, we're on a 3-1 defeat, you know. It's incredible, this game of football.
Well, this is still, in terms of territory and in terms of chances, it's very even, Stephen, but it's Steve McManaman with that one decisive and spectacular break in the first half that's given Liverpool the lead. But away come Bolton again. Lee held up by Babb, and a free kick. Babb got up. Babb, who's already been booked.
Yeah, I don't think there's any real malice in this. It's a 50-50. They both go for it. I think he just falls over him when he runs. But I don't think he did anything wrong, actually.
But it's a free kick for Bolton. Jason McAteer with it. David James with that shaven head now. Stubbs couldn't get to that one. Rush tried to bring McManaman into the play, but it's Thompson instead. And look at Rush deep in his own half getting back there. It's a lesson to all strikers there in the way that you have to go back and do your bit of work as well. And there's no finer example of that than Rush. Deep in his own half there, Kevin.
Yeah, but that's his trademark. I mean, he's much more than a goal scorer. Of course, people will remember him in years to come for his tremendous goal record, and rightly so. But for someone like Fowler playing alongside him, just to learn him things, that it's like Peter Beardsley at Newcastle. He can learn the players so much just if they watch the way he trains, watch his mannerisms, watch the way he behaves.
Well, Snake has put Fowler in here, just inside the Bolton half. Chipping it forward towards McGinley. Ooh, being held there by Ruddock. Referee played the advantage. Bjornaby forcing his way clear. Finds Fowler. Bjornaby's gone on a free run as well. Good, powerful play by Mark Seagraves. McAteer. It's a foul by Redknapp. It'll be a free kick. Towards Paterline, he got his header. Almost arrogant fling out there by David James. Bob Jones playing it down the line.
You know, if you looked at Liverpool 12 months ago, you thought they had all sorts of problems everywhere. And then you look at them now and you think, what? Not only have they got a very good side again, but they've got youngsters in there who are going to be there for a very long time. And suddenly the club looks like the whole of the club's come back in order, if you like, and shows you football what a difference a year can make.
Yes, Seagraves. Scott Green. Came off the head of Scales. Rob Jones with his clearance up towards Ian Rush. Stubbs. Again, driving that long ball out towards David Lee.
Yeah, as the game's progressed, he's got better and better. He's hit three or four superb balls. That was very nearly another one.
McAteer, Bruce Rioch calling his men forward. They'll be looking to McAteer now. Babb gets it away. McAteer again. Great buddies with Phil Babb, actually. A little chat in the corridor before the game started, the pair of them, Babb and McAteer.
Here's Snakers, watch these long. No, that wasn't one of them.
8 times he scored this season, the Dutchman. Started off with Ajax, with the likes of Rijkaard and Bullitz and Van Basten. He's played for a while in Switzerland.
Really got his work cut out in there, because that's where Liverpool punish you. They knock it about and they move so well. And I think most of his work's been chasing shadows in there. And he stuck at it, to be fair to him.
Good jump there by Stubbs. Barnes almost shouldered off the ball, but here's Redknapp taking it. A nice change of direction. A little touch from McManaman. Barnes again playing the simple ball. Here's McManaman. Getting it through to Rush. Played back nicely. Here's McManaman again. And trying to knock that into the path of Fowler.
You get the feeling now that Liverpool are really starting to enjoy this. You know, they feel the game's there for them. I don't think they underestimate Bolton. Of course, 1-0, there's always a chance to get back in it, but they're playing with such fluidity now, and some of the movement in there. Redknapp again starting to assert himself in the game, and he's such a good little player in small triangles. He works wonderful little triangles with people. He's excellent. He's just getting better and better with every game.
McAteer, Katalainen. Don't underestimate Bolton, whatever you do, though. Schneekers. Katalainen. Phillips. Go on, have a go then. Schneekers. Oh, that wasn't what Bolton wanted at all, and Barnes hooks it away. Good pressure here from Bolton. That's a lovely ball by McGinley. And Lee in behind the defenders. Could be something here. Thompson with a header, but he didn't get a right connection. And McManaman can bring it away. He's got Redknapp up alongside him. That wasn't easy for Redknapp to take, but he very nearly headed that into the path of Rush. Rush making it difficult for Stubbs to get it back to Keith Brennigan. Touchline, getting the fullback going now. He's used to coming forward, an ex-midfield player. Barnes going with him though. Gets it back again for David Lee. Oh, because this could be it. No. Thompson. McManaman just stuck a foot out. But just listen to those Bolton fans now. They sense this is a really crucial time. Phillips, and they get a corner.
Yeah, they're really trying to rally the troops now, the Bolton fans. They've been marvellous today. In fact, both sets have, and it's a real credit to the Coca-Cola Cup final, both sets of fans. And you just get the feeling that until Liverpool get that second goal, which possibly most people might feel they deserve, this game's wide open.
Here's Lee, knocking it wide to Sneakers.
He left his shooting boots at home today, well, Brian.
I mean, from the moment I said, watch out, because he's got a powerful shot on him.
Actually, he did make quite good contact with the one just before that, but that sod's law, I think it hit someone straight away, so he never got a chance to see whether that would go anywhere near. But at least he's buying tickets for the raffle. He may just win a prize later on, you know.
This is where Thompson, a great Bolton move, this one, and Lee getting in behind the defenders here, puts a lovely little cross in. Thompson comes across to meet it, but doesn't quite get the purchase on it that was required.
Yeah, he's running at such pace, it's always going to be a difficult chance, but you feel if anyone's going to score for Bolton, it possibly will be Alan Thompson, because he's involved in everything good that they're doing.
They're having a good spell at the moment. It's Lee. This is not over by any means. He shrugged off Guernaby. But he can't shrug off John Barnes. Plays a little ball through to Babb, knocked it forward again to McManaman, touched on again to Fowler, McManaman then reversing it and getting it back to McManaman. All the time Rush is cruising towards the box, Fowler's in there too, but McManaman's there. But it just bobbled, it just lifted a little bit that ball as he set out to strike it.
The ball doesn't bobble at Wembley, Brian.
No. It just had a little bounce on it, Kev, didn't it?
It certainly did, yeah. But again, a great run. Look, defenders hate this. Look at Seagrave trying to get back in, but it just sat up for him, actually.
goal kick to Bolton.
Great little reverse ball in early part of that move from Robbie Fowler. I mean, it's so exciting to watch at times when they're at the best when they're countering you as well. They do it so quickly.
Can Fowler get in behind them? Seagraves nicely in command. Phillips plays a good ball. Here's McAteer, not really asserting himself in this second half. Oh, they were unlucky there, though. It hit the back of Sneakers. Here's Redknapp. Rush. Jones. Barnes. Redknapp. You sense that Liverpool are going to need this second goal. So they've been denied it there, and it's Katalainen taking it up again for Bolton. Scales held him off. No foul. Gernigan. Barnes. The rush. Look at the space on this side now for Rob Jones. Ball taken nicely by him. Should be easy for the keeper.
To me, the significant point is up front, the front two, McGinley and Katalainen. They just haven't got the pace to worry them, so therefore they've got to get hold of the ball, and it's for McAteer and Thompson and people like Lee to break on the Liverpool defence. And it's not really happening so much in this half as it was in the first. But that's where, if they can get hold of it for them, Bolton can get back in this game.
Well, Ben, you were talking about your position yesterday at Chelsea where you just kept sticking at it. I thought, the thing that impresses me about Bolton, and I've seen them several times, they've got great stickability. And all the time, they've got someone like McGinley there who can pull out some really spectacular goals. They're in there with a chance.
Yeah, and he is a very, very good finisher, so he's the one they'll want to get into a scoring position. I mean, he hits the target just about every time, which means goalkeepers have to make saves or his curtains. So I'm not counting them out. They're still in this game at 1-0. They're surviving at the moment more than playing really well, but that's important in football. You have to survive at times.
Fowler does well. Finds Rush. Here's McManaman. Snakers stopped him there. Ruddock. Long way back to David James. Rush again, getting a ball he had no right to get. And a lovely ball by McManaman. Here's Bjørneby with Fowler waiting in the middle. Oh, a ball that was a poor one. Fowler. First ball now for Rob Jones. Bit of space for him to put in a better cross than that, actually. Fowler again, Barnes, Redknapp, Liverpool just knocking it about now, Barnes again, Gernaby on the far side, crossed in there towards Rush, oh wonderful save, a great reaction save there by Brannigan.
Yeah, only Ian Rush could have got on the end of that. I mean, he's outflanked by two defenders.
Peter Shilton, who's of course in the Bolton party, would have appreciated that save. Sorry, Ted.
That's a tremendous save. It came straight at him. I was just saying how Rush got... he was third favourite out of the three there, really, to get to that. And yet he gets a great strike on goal. The keeper, right place at the right time.
Here's Lee. Now Green. Here come Bolton again. Oh. Yes, it's McAteer. Jones in for Redknapp. Played for Barnes. McManaman. Oh, the gap is there through the middle. And Fowler on the far side. And Rush on the far side, rather. Stubbs.
It's really opening up now, the game. It's end-to-end stuff at the moment. And
it's a super game at the moment.
Yeah, both teams looking to do all the positive things, and that's why it's a great game. And, of course, Wembley helps that with such a big pitch.
And it reflects the philosophy of the two managers as well. Thompson.
That's the key. You know, managers want to play that way. They buy the players that do those sort of things.
Thompson going here. Ruddock says, leave that to me. But Scales got there first. Seagraves playing it in. This is a very interesting period of the game now. And you fancy Bolton might yet get something. Here's Phillips with his cross. And David James Very comfortable. McGinley crashed into him, but the big Liverpool goalkeeper just shrugged it off. Redknapp to McManaman. Oh, good play here by McManaman. He might finish it here. A super second goal.
That's just sheer class, Brian. There's no other word for it. This guy is having the time of his life out there on that Wembley pitch. And he's hit the ball over the bar three or four times. Watch this for a run. And the finish. If he was 30 years old, it was Ian Rush, you'd say, well, he does that all the time. Watch it, just a side foot, pass it into the net. Keeper gets a slight hand on it, but there's nothing he can do. And you get the feeling that could open the flood doors.
Guess who the man of the match is going to be? Not much doubt. But look at this lovely finish, as Kevin said. He just places it in there. Brannigan gets the merest of touches, but it's not enough. And Bolton, meantime, has made a substitution. As we see it again there, Goodney Bergson's on at right back in place of Scott Green. Bolton 0, Liverpool 2, both to McManaman. Europe is beginning to beckon as they look for their fifth win in this competition. McAteer chasing it, does well. Lee coming in there, Patalainen very nearly finished it off. Here's Bergson, crossed in by him, Ruddock getting it away. Bergson again, Patalainen again, and a great shot, a wonderful goal by Thompson. That's a sensational goal.
Well, we did say if anyone was going to get a goal for Bolton, I did feel it was going to be this lad. He's a lad I had, actually, so I'll be getting some stick for letting him go, I suppose. But you can't take it away from him. He's been involved in everything positive that they've done. But watch this, his composure, and it just rifles in the corner. I mean, what a goal.
So 2-1 now.
It's amazing, Brian, isn't it? How often when you get a goal, you're at the most vulnerable to concede one. And they say the first two or three minutes after you've scored is the most
worrying. That's when you've got to get your tackles in, isn't it?
Yeah, but you can't do much about that. I mean, it was just a classic goal. Tremendous strike.
I mean, the composure of the young fellow, he had it on his chest and turned it. And yeah. I mean, it was an amazing piece of skill.
It's as if he said to James, try and keep this one out, pal. You kept the last one out, you're not getting this one. It was a tremendous strike.
So McManaman, the scorer here of two, offside against Fowler, 23 years old, and a response from Alan Thompson, 21 years old. Here's Goodney Bergson, the substitute, who's on. Spurs fans will remember him well. Bolton signed him just before the deadline. He'd gone back to Iceland, in fact, his native country. There's still a lot left in this cup final. Phillips. Schnakers. Schnakers again. Up goes McManaman, but he's hasn't got the power there. This Bergson is charging everywhere. Stops. Scales with a header clear. Balls to Seagrave. Scales again. Barnes couldn't get hold of that one. Snakers did, and he wanted Patalainen to come towards him. Fowler finding Rush. Redknapp finding the dangerous McManaman. And he's on a hat-trick. But not with a shot, not that.
This game, Brian, is a great advert for both the Premier League and the Ends League. This is a tremendous goal from Alan Thompson. Just waits for it, doesn't snatch at it, Brian. And I mean, look.
Oh, they're wonderful pictures, too. And I mean, that's an amazing readjustment of his whole body to get that volley on the turn like that. Here's Lee. Here's Bolton. Too high. such a grand club, Bolton. Three times they won the cup back in the 1920s. And in fact, watching today, the oldest Bolton fan, I would have thought, 105 on July the 4th, is a gentleman called James Bradley, down in a village in Herefordshire. And his father, William Bradley, I'm gather, was a full-back for Bolton. He remembers the 1923 final when they played here. Well, I hope he's enjoying, as you are at home, this terrific cup final here. Let's get a word with Terry in just a moment as we watch Phillips coming forward.
He was probably here in 1923, was he? Because there's about 180,000 here, wasn't
there? That's right. They beat West Ham 2-0, Bolton. The White Horse final. Here's Bergson. Towards Thompson. No foul. In fact, it's a handball by Thompson. Well, Terry Venables, this is some second half.
It's fantastic. It really has gone up another notch. And the first half was a good one. But it's quite interesting that Liverpool put McManam on the right side when they started the game, and Bolton got hold of the game, and they lost that variety. Barnes called him across to the left, and from there he got the goal. Bingo. And of course, Thompson's goal was magnificent. The way he shifted his body out of the way when he got that volley in was quite magnificent.
I mean, that's a super bit of skill, actually, the whole rearrangement of the body to get that sort of volley in.
I think something else I should point out, to be fair, he had a horrific car accident, Brian, when he was travelling back from a game with some lads.
Who, Thompson did?
Yes, he did, and a lot of people thought he wouldn't play again. And, I mean, he battled away, got himself back fit again, and I'm so pleased for him, you know, that he's got what he deserves today, a goal, because he's put in a very mature performance. Still trying to score that first goal, Brian. He's had three or four attempts today, but the one that hit the post will probably be the best
one. Oh, look at that, Nat Lofthouse in the light suit there, and look who's sitting alongside him, Tom Finney. Now, two of the great characters, and two of the great gentlemen of English football. It's wonderful. Well, they could do with a little of the Lofthouse spirit, which they've already shown, and who knows, this cup final is a long way from being over. Tom Finney, of course, from Preston North End. Preston Plummer. Makes you wonder, actually, when you see the guest of honour today, Stanley Matthews, Tom Finney and Matt Loftus.
It's not a bad forward line, though. Just thinking.
Be worth a few bob today. Here's Snakers. Phillips. Made a good little run in there, but Phillips ignored him and tried to find Pavlainen. It's now with Bergson. Lee. That was surely an obstruction, and that's going to be a foul. That's going to be a yellow card for Bjørnaby.
Well, the one thing about Philip Donner's referee, he is so consistent. I mean, he just books everybody who breaks the rules. And I suppose with the interpretation that FIFA want, he's the perfect referee. That's why he's getting so many big games, you know?
Well, the yellow card for him. There's the free kick for Bolton. Not very well played in, as it happens. McAteer might pick it up. Philip Don was telling me before the game today, his job is to protect all the players but to punish the ones who stray, and he's done that. And here's McManaman. Fowler's gone in there, but he couldn't pick it up. It wasn't an easy ball for Robbie Fowler to pick up after that great run again by McManaman. And suddenly Bolton, who looked quite threatening on the counter break, McAteer, who will run at them. McManaman's got back. Here's Thompson. Will we show too much of that to Rob Jones? Redknapp, Rush, Redknapp.
John Barnes again there, Brian. Just a simple ball, but it's so important you get it early, and that's what he's doing. And he's like conducting an orchestra out there. And I'm so pleased for him because he didn't have the best of nights on Wednesday.
Here's Redknapp. Tried a shot, charged down. It's McAteer. This could be interesting. They've got Catalainen and McKinley up front. McKinley. But Liverpool have pulled everybody back. Schneegels. Finding Bergson. It's Lee again. Flitting down that right touchline, the ball just in play, and he gets a corner.
I think it was Ron Atkinson who remarked about how wide he stays. I mean, I think he gets a bonus if he gets a line on his shoes. He runs the line more than anybody ever known, this guy, apart from the linesman. Tremendous. If his delivery had been a little bit better today, then he would be another one who, when he has got in the game, has played well. But his final ball hasn't been as good as I think it could be.
Their corners haven't been too good, but let's see what they do here. Thompson flicking it in. That's a much better one. McAteer. Let's have a quick word with Ron Atkinson. Ron, if you were in Bruce Rioch's shoes now, would you change very much, or would you just say, let's have more of the same?
Hey, not much more, Brian, because they're playing very, very well, Bolton. I feel this half, he's probably switched the midfield players around a little bit and asked McAteer to sit a little bit more and let Sneakers run on. I think as the game gets towards its close, if the game stays like this, I think you'll probably say to McAteer, gamble a little bit and, you know, we'll throw caution to the wind, if you like. But at the moment, they're playing very, very well, Bolton.
Are you enjoying it?
Oh, it's a blinding game. Blinding game.
Well done, Ron, thank you. Fowler now to McManaman. Bjornaby's outside him. Cross towards Fowler. And what about a calm piece of play? A nerveless piece of play there by Alan Stubbs. Scales with that header. Bad ducking in and finding Barnes, conducting that orchestra, as Kevin says, here it is again, playing the ball forward, but not a very good piece of conducting there, because it goes straight to Stubbs, who drives this ball forward too far.
I'll be amazed, Brian, if two or three of these players don't go down with cramp shortly. I mean, it's been played at a terrific pace, it's a very hot day, although the sun's now just about gone out of the stadium, it's still fairly hot by English standards for beginning of April.
This is Redknapp. Hits it straight at the keeper, but it was a good run and it was a lovely little layoff by McManaman that set him on his way. Up goes Ruddock, wins it comfortably in the air. Here's McManaman. Barnes, playing the simple ball. Barnes, free kick. Here's Redknapp. McManaman. Wanna be outside him again. Ball still met McManaman. Now with Rush. And now with Fowler.
It's incredible, but McManaman is still running at them. I mean, he's been doing it all the game, and he's still doing it, and no one seems to have stopped him. And I know it's difficult because we had a problem with it, but you'd think they'd find a way, or it just doesn't seem to happen with him. He gets in that no-man's land where he can cause so many problems without being picked up.
This must be a good thing. I've just looked at the watch and realised there's only 10 minutes to go. Time has flown past in this second half.
Time flies when you're enjoying yourself, man. It's a great game.
Rush well wide that time. Bring out that old statistic again. He needs just two to equal Jeff Hurst's 49 goals in this competition. Actually, we caught a sight of Roy Evans there. Just to—I mean, you would have known him in your Anfield days.
Yeah, I was very disappointed when he went onto the staff, because I used to play against him. He was in the reserve side in the practice matches, and Shankly said, "Just run him, you'll get your confidence up." And at about 26, he went on the staff. He was talked into it, funny enough, by Ronnie Moran, who was sat next to him there. And he's done a tremendous job. They've promoted from within, and I always feel that's the way at Liverpool. And he's such a nice guy. But I think he's got a little streak in him that will make him a great manager as well.
Well, he's about 8 minutes away from winning a major trophy here. Here's Lee. 30 years Roy Evans has been at Anfield, starting as an apprentice just before Liverpool won the cup here in 1965.
Shankly used to say his pace was deceptive, Brian. He's slower than he looks. That's what he used to say to me. But he was only laughing with him, you know. But if you cut him open, it'd just say Liverpool through and through like a stick of rock, and that's what clubs are built on. And Ronnie's not losing too much more air these days. No. It's pleasing to see.
Like that. Some of us, there's not much more to lose. It's a throw to Liverpool. Here's Phil Babb. Moving it towards Rush, pushed down by Phillips, Stubbs, forward to McGinley, it's Barnes, 7.5 minutes left, McManaman, that's a free shot, and I think Goodney Ferguson's going to get a yellow card.
Well, I think Philip Don, as I said before, has made it perfectly clear. If you do anything that's against the rules, you're going to book you. And of course, some of them you might think are petty, but this is against the rules. His body checked him, and it's free kick, and he's booked him.
Here comes a free kick. In a long way. I think it was Stubbs, or maybe Seagraves, who got the header away. Barnes hammering in amongst the Liverpool fans.
Just thinking there, Brian, we're back in the same situation I think we found ourselves in a lot this season, where we say there hasn't really been a bad tackle in the game, apart maybe from Alan Thompson's rash one, which he unfortunately didn't connect with, and yet we've had something like 6 buckets.
Katalainen. Oh, here's McGinley. There's the threat again to Liverpool. 5 bookings.
Yeah, it's a lot for a game that really has been played in what I would say is a perfect spirit, you know. It's nothing, you know, it's a man's game, it's been played correctly, but it's not been over physical, has it? And yet you see 5 bookings. 2 years ago you'd say it'd been a really fierce, ferocious type game with a lot of bad tackling. Not been the case.
Here's Stubbs. Again, Lee. Here's McAteer. Bergson. Here's Snakers. And look at Rush coming back there. And it cannoned off the defender into the arms of David James. But it was Rush, 2 yards outside his own penalty area, making the important challenge.
That's what makes great players great. They're not. He's not just a goal scorer, as I said before. He's a workhorse as well when he has to be. And I remember the great Johan Cruyff saying, if I'm not playing well, I work for Johan Neeskens, and he conducts the orchestra, if you like. And that's a sign of greatness, and Rushy's got that. There's no doubt about it.
Snakers. Been impressed by the amount of work he's done.
Yes,
he's on the ball now.
He's worked very hard. He's stuck at his task. He hasn't had as much of the ball as he would like because he's been chasing a lot of people.
McAteer with the shot. Real whiplash shot there by McAteer. No real backlift.
Yeah, he doesn't quite connect with it, and the keeper's diving, but he already knows when he's diving that that's going wide.
Inside the last 5 minutes, Liverpool leading 2-1. Can Bolton yet save themselves in this enthralling Coca-Cola Cup final? It's with Richard Snakers again. McAteer is down. Cramp.
Yeah, there's my bet up. I'm having a good day with the bets. I know I had a bad World Cup with the injury, but I'm getting my points back now.
Right, here comes McManaman. It's a lovely run of his today. Finding Fowler. Gonna be. Red map. McManaman. Barnes. Yes, McManaman. McManaman just offside. Don't forget there's some terrific football coming up on ITV this coming week. There's the Champions League highlights on Wednesday at 10:40, that's in most regions. And do make a date the following night for Arsenal against Sampdoria in the Cup Winners' Cup. That's Thursday live at 10 minutes to 8. Arsenal versus Sampdoria this year. Up goes Ruddock, wins it well. But it's now with Seagraves. Katalainen. Schnakers. 2.5 minutes on the watch now. Phillips. Out comes James. It's unlike Liverpool to give away crucial goals in the last minutes of a game like this. And Rooney Moran wanting them to push forward and push forward. And here's David James, who's going to bang that ball forward now.
Yeah, that's a good point, Brian. 10 years ago, Liverpool would have kept it, knocked it back to the goalkeeper, back to the fullback, and killed the game. But with the new rules, you can't do it anymore. And this game's got to go all the way, and you know, you've got to keep taking risks because the rules make you.
Phillips, Schnakers. Well, they have the Alan Hardacre Trophy for the man of the match, chosen by journalists here. Guess who it is? Steve McManaman, who's been absolutely brilliant, both the Liverpool goals and so much more besides to thrill these Liverpool fans.
Yeah, that would be one of the easiest tests they've had this year, the journalists, I think.
And here is the man of the match on the ball again. Just knocking it back to Puenaby, and here's Barnes. Down the touchline again towards McManaman, the ball out of play, it's a Liverpool throw. Coming to the last minute of the game now. Redknapp. Liverpool just a minute or so away from winning the competition for a record fifth time. Aston Villa four times winners. Barnes knows it's not the time to do anything silly. It's the time to do things that are safe. Redknapp caught badly there.
And suddenly a good counter-attack on McGinley.
Just chipping it forward, and Scales gets in with a header.
You know, if Bolton had just produced better final balls from the last third, they would have caused Liverpool a lot more problems. That really summed up sometimes where they've fallen down. You know, the good situation, three against three, and he chose the wrong option for me. But I think both Colin Todd and Bruce Rioch would be delighted. They've come here, they've shown no fear. They've taken the game to Liverpool when it's been possible, and when they've had to defend, they've all stood up and all been counted. And I think they can be really proud of what they've done, but I don't think they're going to get anything out of this game now.
Here's Barnes. Well, they've been a credit to themselves and to the Ensley League. Yonaby at Liverpool now doing what they do so well. Just playing it around. But you see, James has got to hammer this one clear, and McGinley was going to try and panic in. No, they think it's the final whistle. There are people on the field. There are cameramen on the field. They'll have to get off. That was just a free kick to Bolton. Bolton say it's not over yet. We might have yet something to say for ourselves. And they might, because they've now got a free kick right on the edge of the box. The last seconds. We are well into time added on. Schnakers has got a fantastic shot on him. But so too has Alan Stubbs. And David James will need to know that that wall is correctly and securely lined up. Now, will it be Schnakers? It's not. It's neither of them.
It's going to be Alan Thompson, and he's got a hell of a dig on him.
And it came off Robbie Fowler. No, Jamie Redknapp. It's not over yet. Bolton still deep in Liverpool's half. Phillips to the captain, Alan Stubbs. Long range shot, goal kick, and it probably is over now.
Yeah, looking for fairy tales there was Alan Stubbs, and you can't blame him, because they do happen in football. but he just got underneath a little bit, and Roy Evans will have breathed a sigh of relief there.
Everybody else on their feet around him, and he's trying to remain nice and calm, but you can imagine the pride that he's feeling now for Liverpool. A man who's worked under Shankly and under Paisley and Fagan and Dalglish and Graham Souness, has now brought a Liverpool side of his own to Wembley and is now just a matter of seconds away from winning it. Liverpool win the Coca-Cola Cup. They win it by 2-1. Roy Evans has made his mark as a Liverpool manager and gets the congratulations from the bench. The man of the match, Steve McManaman, with both the goals. And maybe the best goal of all, that fantastic effort from Alan Thompson brought Bolton back into the game to provide us with a Coca-Cola Cup final to remember. And the Bolton players on the field, lying down, dejected, some of them.
Yeah, it's an old saying, Brian, but the winners can laugh and the losers do have to make their own arrangements. And I've known the feeling. I've been in a cup final, an FA one, that is, and been on the winning side, and that's everything. And I tell you, there's no fun for the losers, even though you've come all this way and done very well. You see that with Alan Thompson there.
They will console themselves by saying that our real task now is to make sure we get into the Premiership next season. They took Liverpool to the limits, don't worry about that. And it was the brilliant play of Steve McManaman with his two goals that made the vital difference. Crowd now acknowledging Steve McManaman as the man of the match. Let's go and hear from the man of the match with Gary Newbon.
Steve, congratulations, you're the man of the match. The press made you the man of the match today. A tremendous performance by you as an individual.
Yeah, I mean, that's all right scoring the goals, but I mean, it's a great team effort. They battled very well in the second half, like we thought they'd do. And we've managed to hold on, but we were breaking away near the end as well.
At the end of the day, it was a great save by David James, and two individual runs by you that was the difference, though, as far as the scoring was concerned.
Yeah, I mean, I think we had our chances breaking away. J-Mo made a couple of great saves, once in the first half. And, I mean, it's an all-round team performance, that's what matters.
Stay there just a second, we'll bring your captain. Tremendous performance by Steve today, Ian Rush.
Yeah, it was absolutely magnificent. He scored two great individual goals. We've gone well as a team today, but I think them two goals did stand out.
And for you, you're the first person ever to get five winning medals at Wembley.
Well, I'll hope to get six next year. Yeah, I'll still be around, so... It's just great to be able for the fans, really, because they've won for a few years, but it's great to lift the cup as captain.
And for you, you're back in Europe now.
That's what I've been waiting for. No, the fans deserve Europe, and we'll pit our wits against the best in European football next year.
And a word about Bolton.
Well, they battled hard. You know, they're 2-0 down, and they came back, and they kept it going. You know, they have to fight for 90 minutes.
Steve, final word. I mean, Bolton did put up a good performance against you from the First Division.
Yeah, the last two times we played, and they beat us, so... It's good to get a win over them for once.
And good for the old man, Ian Rush, there.
Well, he's achieved everything now, and he goes up as captain to lift it.
Final question about Roy Evans. I mean, it's his first trophy.
Captain's done a magnificent job. A lot of people wrote us off at the beginning of the season. We've come back with one of the three major trophies.
Steve, congratulations. Great day for you individually. Good day for Liverpool.
Well, Ian Rush, then, with five winners' medals now, and I'm sure Liverpool fans won't escape. Will have heard what he said. I'll be back for another one next year. Home Secretary with Stanley Matthews. Well, I think our guest of honour today would have been enthralled by that performance by Liverpool and Bolton.
Roy, congratulations, your first year, your first trophy for Liverpool.
Well, it's obvious for them, they're the lads who've earned it. They've done it the hard way today. I don't think we've played particularly well, but we've got a great result, and that's what matters.
Well, you had one great save by your goalkeeper, and also Seaton played particularly well, but two great goals by McManaman.
Yeah, we did. Two great goals. But Bolton put the pressure on us, they never lay down, they worked hard, and it's been a great day. I mean, the two sides have gotten really well, and
hope the fans of the same tonight. A few pints and enjoy it.
And you're in Europe next season.
Well, that's the biggest thing. It's great to win a trophy. Delighted.
Thanks, Roy. Well done.
Well, it's a tradition in the League Cup finals, the Coca-Cola Cup final. The losers come up first. Alan Stubbs, a lion-hearted defender for Bolton. Let's have a quick word with the Bolton manager, Bruce Rioch.
Bruce, a very good performance by Bolton. Didn't work out for you in the end, but gosh, you fought hard in a tremendous second half.
First half was the area in which we may have lost the game, although they scored the second one second half. We just felt that we had to go out second half and play without any fear factor. And one or two first half were a little bit nervous, obviously, but we always felt we just had got to take the game to Liverpool. And the second one hurt us, obviously, but when you get a goal back, you have a little bit of hope. But very pleased for our players, but obviously delighted for Roy as well. Good finder.
You gave them a hard time. It's a great experience for your team.
Brilliant experience. It's not a young side, but it's a young side in terms of playing at this level in these type of games, and it will benefit them in the long term.
You looked a Premiership side as well today.
There's always going to be a hard game against a team like Liverpool, but obviously the boys have done very well. I'm very pleased with them, very well indeed.
Okay,
thanks, Gary.
And now the turn of the winners. A familiar climb of 39 steps for Ian Rush, picking up his fifth winner's medal. Now captain of Roy Evans' team. Roy thought they hadn't played so well today, but they played well enough to win, and well enough, no doubt, for the Liverpool fans and for the neutrals watching at home to have thoroughly enjoyed an exciting Coca-Cola Cup final. And as Rushy says, who knows, I could be back again next year as well. A terrific all-round performance by him. Well, and when you look at the Liverpool squad, they are the ones who couldn't get into the side. A cup from Sir Stanley Matthews for Ian Rush. It's Liverpool again. For the accompaniment of fireworks. That really is a familiar scene, Kevin. Liverpool in the red shirts up there in the winner's rostrum.
I wonder how many Liverpool fans thought it would happen that quickly. Tremendous credit to everyone at the club. I saw Mr. Moore's the chairman there. He came over, took over at a difficult time. A lot of people, sometimes they think it's the chairman's fault and that, but he stuck by Roy, appointed him. The players have played for him, and they're back in Europe. I suppose the last time Bolton were in Europe, Pirates must have attacked the supporters ferry, it's that long ago, but they go away with the head held high. It's been a tremendous game. I've really enjoyed it.
Were you surprised that Roy said they hadn't played that well?
No, I'm not surprised, because I think at Liverpool they always tend to underestimate. You don't see them shouting stuff from the rooftops and how well we played. I think they played tremendously today. I don't want to disagree with the manager, but I think it was a bit tongue-in-cheek. I think when he watches the video, what he maybe means is sometimes when you sat down there, Brian, at that level, you just don't really get a true pattern of the game.
Kevin, thanks very much. Liverpool have won the Coca-Cola Cup, and we now take another short break.
Well, these are the scenes at Wembley Stadium. Liverpool Football Club have won the Coca-Cola League Cup. It's a record, a fifth win. They're celebrating, going round the stadium. But really, the story tonight is that we have a smile back on football, I think, tonight, after all the problems in the game, because we've had a game played in terrific spirit, open, attacking, entertaining football, and hugely skillful as well, as I'm sure Terry Venables and Ron Atkinson would agree. Terry?
Yeah, it was terrific for the game. I thought it was a wonderful match. It was a good first half, even better second half. All the things that we love about the game. Good passing, great shots. And to cap it all, even though it was a consolation goal, I thought Bolton's goal was a wonderful effort.
Yeah. Let's start with McManaman, because he's your man. He's important for England. I mean, on this sort of display, let's have a look. This is the first goal.
Yeah, Barnsley just, it's a nice ball through. He collects it there. As I said before, Fowler's to his left, and he could have slid him in there. He decides to go alone and go into his favoured right-hand side, gets away from Stubbs, and he can't actually get there. Just slips it by the fullback, and again, as we see, the goalkeeper, as Ron said, on a good day, would have hoped he would have stopped that.
Now then, Ron, this is the second goal. Class all the way through, isn't it?
Yeah, it's switched over to the left-hand side at this stage of the game, McManaman. Now, watch what this is what he's good at. He checks, slows the fullback up, and then makes the spurt. I just wonder whether Jason McAteer maybe felt he should have double-banked him there. Oh, yeah. But once he's gone past the second man, that is absolute classic. Lovely, lovely finish, that.
Yeah, absolutely brilliant. Now, of course, this goal from Alan Thompson as well.
Well, he was facing his own goal. He's got to, what he's got to achieve, he's got to turn and face the goal there and remove his body out of the way so that he can get a good, clean hit at the ball, and that's exactly what he does do.
I think we should hear from Alan Thompson. He's down with one or two of the other Bolton players. They're talking to Jim Rosenthal.
Well, Alan, you've seen your goal, but you look a little bit tearful.
Yeah, I think the lads will be very disappointed. I don't think we played so well first off. I think we come out second half and we seem to take the game to Liverpool a bit. Had a few chances and Steve McManaman managed to get another goal. And we got one back. But I think they moved the ball a bit well for us at times.
John, it's a desperately hard place to come and lose. But really, you did Bolton and the NZ League proud this afternoon.
Yeah, I think especially second half, Jim. I thought we played really well. And Liverpool left us hit us on the break. And I thought we took the game to them in the second half. And a great goal by Steve McManaman to win the game.
Hey, you've been beaten, you would appreciate, as a skilled player, by two moments of great individual brilliance here.
Yeah, I think he done two sheer moments of magic when he scored his goals. And but I think you saw a lot more of his game as well. Some good vision, some good defensive work. Yeah, very good player, Steve McManaman.
John, you're obviously down now, but there's a lot to play for this season. I think you've shown you could hold your own in the Premiership.
I think now we've got a big game in Wednesday against Swindon Town. We've got to get our minds on that now and start looking back towards promotion.
Well done, both of you. I'll tell you on behalf of us all, it was a smashing game.
Thank you, Jim. Cheers. Thank you.
Well, we certainly all endorse that sentiment from Jim Rosenthal. And here's the man of the match. There's Steve McManaman. They're around their own fans now. We'll have some more chat in a few moments. We're off for a short break. Welcome back to Wembley Stadium. Liverpool have won the Coca-Cola Cup 2-1 against Bolton. And it's been a really, really wonderful game. Second half even surpassed the first, Ron, didn't it?
Yeah, I mean, I've enthralled. I could have done with extra time. I don't think Roy Evans would have liked it, but I wouldn't have minded a little bit of extra time on that one. Smashing. Bright, open, attacking play. As we say, as we've said earlier, capped by three great goals.
Yes. I think Bolton deserve terrific credit as well, Terry.
I think that's right, and I thought McKinley made the point after the game that they've got a very important game in the week now, and there's no time for crying. They've got to actually say, OK, we'll give it a good shot, we played our part and we were terrific, get back in the game again.
Now, Liverpool have won enough trophies in their time, haven't they? But here they are, there's another one on the sideboard. What do you think about the future of Liverpool, Ron?
I think that was very important for them to win something quickly. Gets them back into Europe, as they say, and that gives them the platform. You know, they've rated themselves always a European club. They haven't been there for, say, a couple of years. Now it gives them, it makes it harder for us because it gives them more wherewithal to go and spend again, doesn't it, and buy bigger players. But I always think Liverpool in Europe's great for the country.
Yeah, and Roy Evans, I think he's 30 years he's been at Anfield from the time he was a player.
Yeah, he's always been. He's thought highly of. by everybody at the club, and he's the sort of guy that you hope to that will win things, and I think we're all delighted for him.
Yeah, you'd endorse that as well, Ron?
Oh, very much so, yeah. He's a great little fella, and he's waited long enough for it.
Well, we've all enjoyed it. Thanks very much for your company again. Let me just remind you of a very big European week coming up on ITV. On Wednesday night at 10:40 in most regions, we'll have coverage of the Champions Cup semi-final first legs. Paris Saint-Germain against AC Milan, Bayern Munich against Ajax. What a lineup that is. Three previous winners involved there. And then on Thursday evening, live from Highbury at 7:50, Arsenal against Sampdoria in the semi-final of the Cup Winners' Cup. The holders up against the favourites. Some really great, great action to come, only on ITV. But today, well, it was Liverpool's day, just. And thanks to a fantastic goal from 23-year-old Steve McManaman, scorer of the opening goal of the game, and then this mazy dribble before, as Kevin Keegan said, passing the ball with real composure and class into the back of the net, making it 2-1. And we just say, well done, Liverpool. Well done, Roy Evans. Thanks as well to Bolton. Coca-Cola League Cup is on its way to Anfield for a record fifth time. Liverpool are also back in Europe. Well done to all of them from all of us. Bye-bye.